Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Paradise. If you are new to my channel, thank you so much for stopping by. If you are a new subscriber, thank you so much for subscribing. You guys, I've had a lot of subscribers within this past few weeks, so I just want to say thank you, and I hope that you enjoy the content. So we're gonna jump straight into the video because I think my battery is running low and I'm trying to get this video recorded for y'all. So first off, as you guys can see, I am in a different setting. There's been a lot going on, a lot of new changes, exciting changes, just a lot going on. I will talk to y'all about that in another video. But today we are going to talk about my first Black Friday experience. Whew. Let's talk about it. So overall, I had a great first Black Friday experience. I honestly got way more orders than I expected to get, not to be, you know, pessimistic or anything, but for the work I put in, I got a lot more orders than I expected. But you guys, Black Friday wore me out, okay? It wore me out. By the time Black Friday, the actual Friday, got here, I was done for. Like, literally, I only posted one time per day over that weekend, which is why I said I got a lot more than I expected. Not that I didn't deserve it, because I worked really hard up to that day. But like, when the day came, by that time, I was just burned out because, you know, it was a holiday time. We had been working throughout that week. My husband was actually doing a construction job, and I was helping him do that. So in between doing that and preparing for my first Black Friday, I was tired, y'all, by the time Friday came. So I literally only posted one time per day, but I did really well for my first Black Friday. I would say I'm very proud of myself, but I will tell you guys what I would have done differently. So that's what I want to talk about. This experience taught me nothing else. It taught me to plan early and plan often. That is where I feel like I fell short. That's why I know I fell short. So I'm a really good long-term planner. Like, I can plan deep into next year. But when it comes to short-term things, I kind of just like go with the flow, or I'll procrastinate and I'll wait till the last minute to do things. And I'm realizing, I mean, I already knew it's not a good habit anyway. I knew it when I was in school. I know it's not a good habit. But it's really not a good habit for business, because it just all builds up. And that's what happened to me. That's why I got so overwhelmed. So I literally waited until like the last 2 weeks before Black Friday to really start prepping for Black Friday. And honestly, I waited till that week before to really start prepping. So I'm gonna give you guys a few tips, a few things that I think you should do as far as planning. That's all this video is gonna be about, is planning for Black Friday. But it can, you know, this can account for any type of big sale that you have going on or anything like that. Just to plan early and plan often, okay you guys? So I'm gonna give you a few tips, things I think you should do for your business when it comes to planning for big sales. So the first tip I will give is to establish what deals you're gonna do early. I'm talking months in advance. Get an idea of what items you wanna sell, what the prices you want them to be, whether you're doing bundle deals or specific items, so that you'll know how much of what you need to make, how much you need to order, and you kind of get an idea. And it'll also help you to plan your content. So it'll help you to plan what you're going to be posting that month, because if you're really trying to sell your blankets, you want to be posting your blankets the most during that month of Black Friday, so that leading up to it, people can see it. Order products at least 30 days in advance, especially if we're talking about Black Friday. You guys, this is the prime shopping time. So everyone is buying, everyone is selling. Mail carriers are overloaded. Make sure you order your stuff in time, because more than likely there will be a delay, especially if it's coming from another country or, you know, wherever you have your stuff coming from. Be sure to order your stuff at least 30 days in advance if we're talking about Black Friday. If we're talking about another time in the year, maybe you don't have to order that far out, but I mean, I will from now on either way, because I want to make sure that my things are here on time. To go with that, I would also say to prepare your products before. It kind of goes hand in hand, because it kind of depends on what you make. So, you know, you order your products if you don't actually hand make your products, but if you do hand make them, make sure you're giving yourself enough time to make and prepare your products. So an example is, I sell handmade candles. Those are created by me, poured by me. Everything is handmade, but it takes time for those candles to cure. They're supposed to cure for at least 5 to 7 days. However, me being the last minute person I am, I literally did not create some of those candles until like 2 days before. before Black Friday. And not only did I have to create the candles, but I have to package the candles so that I can take pictures of the candles. So y'all see why I ran into a problem there. So yeah, prepare your products and order your products early, at least 30 days in advance if you're ordering them. And I would say probably about 2 weeks in advance if you are making them, depending on what you're making. It really depends on what you're making, honestly. So you're supposed to post your products early. So as soon as you know what you're gonna be, what deals you're gonna be running, you know the prices and everything, start getting that out there. Once again, at least 2 weeks in advance. I see people doing it a month in advance, whatever, but just so you can get it in people's heads. Like I told you guys in the last video, it's been said that it takes people at least 8 times to see your brand or your products before they purchase. So if you're just posting something 2 days before Black Friday, you can't really expect too many sales unless it's just a bomb product and, you know, it sells itself. You know, it happens. But realistically, you have to kind of lead up to it so that people know what to expect, so that people can have their coins ready. You know, they have to make sure they have enough depending on your product. If they already have in their mind what they're going to buy for Black Friday, they've been looking through the sales, and then you just pop up the day before, you know, you might miss that mark. So that's another thing that I definitely fell short on. I definitely sold my marketing down leading up to Black Friday, once again, because I was just doing way too much in my everyday life and business life, everything. It was a little bit too much going on for me to where I got overwhelmed. And I did the most of my posting that Thursday. And that Friday, actually, on Black Friday, which was a big, big mistake for me on my part. And then, like I said, I didn't even post really at all over that weekend. So make sure you post early. Make sure you're posting often the products that you really want to get out there for Black Friday or whatever big sale that you have going on. These are all things that I believe I fell short on. And I know that I could have done so much better for Black Friday if I had done these things. But once again, it was my first Black Friday. I honestly am grateful for what I got. I think I did great for my first Black Friday, but you know, you live and you learn. So I just want to help you guys out with that. So for next season, we all gonna get our coins, because we gonna do right. We gonna plan early and we gonna plan often. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Stay tuned for more videos to come. Like I said, I am in a new setting, so expect it to switch up a little bit until I find the right setting for me. I'm kind of just playing around with stuff to see what I like. I'm still even moving my stuff in right now, so I have stuff everywhere. I just really want to get some videos out to you guys because it's been a while and I have a lot to share with y'all. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps me. And make sure that you are subscribed and make sure you hit that bell right next to us to be notified each and every time I upload. I appreciate you guys, and I will see you in the next video.